One of the more difficult things to achieve as an IT professional is consistency in your change management process. Because changes can come from all over your organization, anyone could be writing them, and sometimes you really don't have time to think about what you're doing if it's an emergency change. But one of the ways you can really help that is by templatizing your change requests. So let me show you how to do that in SolarWinds Service Desk. So from your main dashboard, we're going to go ahead down to Service Desk and change catalog. And we're going to go ahead and build a new change management template. This one is going to be for upgrading router firmware. The description is upgrade router firmware to version X. So let's go ahead and build our change plan. There's a lot of steps involved in doing a router firmware upgrade, so let's go ahead and do it step by step. So the first thing we're going to do is copy the firmware image over to the deployment server. We're going to validate the MD5 hash on that image, confirm communication between the deployment server and the router using whatever protocol is necessary. We're going to back up the existing images from the router to the deployment server, and we're going to call that a legacy image. We're going to capture the running configuration on the router. We're going to copy the new image from the deployment server to the router. Then we're going to update the configuration to include the new firmware. We're going to save that config, and then we're going to reload the router. So that's the change plan for this. So let's go ahead and think about what our rollback plan is going to be. So the most common scenario here is when you actually deploy this, the image goes onto the router and reboots and it starts using that image, but it doesn't fix your problem. So let's go ahead and go over the rollback plan for that. So if the new image is active on the router and issue still persists, copy the legacy image from the deployment server back to the router and restore the configuration from backup. Then just reload the router. In this scenario, the test plan is really easy. Just get on the router and validate that you have the new firmware. For this particular scenario, I'm going to go ahead and select my type as standard. I'm going to leave that priority at medium. This actually could be any site, so I'm going to leave it blank. For the department, it's IT. And the default group is going to be the network team. You can add additional fields, and for me, I would want to capture the before and after versions. So legacy firmware version, which is of type text, and make it mandatory. And then new firmware version, which is also text and is also mandatory. And for my scenario, that's all I need. So I'm going to go ahead and click create. And there it is. You can see the change template is in there as a draft type. So that's the basics of a normal template. You can, of course, add additional processes on the backside, but I want to show you an example of an emergency template that we've already built. So let's go ahead and look at that. So let's look at replace hard drive in server. Seems pretty standard. We have the description, the change plan, rollback, test plan. We have the type, where it is, who's responsible, what the priority is. Because this is an emergency change and time is of the essence, we want to make sure everything is documented as quickly as possible. So we automate some of those processes. We set it to in progress. We send it to the emergency change board for approval. If it is approved, we get a backup, we replace the drive, we format the new drive, we restore it, we confirm that restore, and then we flag it as complete. On the off chance that it's declined, we go ahead and change the state to declined. So because this was an emergency change, we wanted to make sure we had that process really well documented. But not just emergency changes should have this. You should actually take the time and build them out. There's no reason we couldn't have built those in as additional process steps for our router firmware upgrade template. They would have been perfectly fine. In fact, the closer you get to kind of get standardized, the better your change management is going to be overall.